Hi there. In this episode, I'm going to show you how you can build your own AI chatbot using Python, Flask, and Llama. You can use any local LLM you like. On Llama site, you can see how many LLMs you can choose. I'm going with Devstra since I will be using it later in the series to interact with network devices via function calling. And this LLM is very good for software engineering tasks, so I will choose that one. Let's start by setting up Llama. So let's download this on my computer. So I choose Windows, click download and install it. After that, we can go to our command line and type llama pull devstra. And now we are pulling our LLM to our computer. You need to have space for that. That one is taking almost 20 gigabytes. In the next step, I will show you my Flask environment. So I'm going to VMware and I'm running a virtual machine on Ubuntu. It will be better if I connect using SSH, and I'm running it on Docker. So let's go to opt source, and I have here a Docker file. So I'm using image with Python, and then using pip, I'm just installing requirements where I have all needed libraries to work with Flask, with MongoDB that I'm running, and Llama. Then I will show you my Docker Compose. So here I have MongoDB, then Mongo Express to look files in that, and Docker Flask, where I'm using a Docker Flask image that I am building from that Docker file. I'm attaching my volumes, and then I'm exposing port 8001. I'm configuring DNS, restart always, and I'm attaching also network to have static IPs for my MongoDB and other services, and that's all. So I'm using Llama on my Windows PC, but Flask is hosted in Docker on my Ubuntu in VMware. As you can see, I have a lot of lines here because this is my old project. It's actually part of tool I'm building to manage and monitor network infrastructure. I've already built some pages and views for it, and now I wanted to expand it with AI chatbot interface. So this is only part of the tool that I created. We have here a database when I'm adding petrol stations. Python is adding new ID. We are only providing location, subnet is generated, public IP is something that we will add later, and we can configure and getting facts from that device that can be Cisco, Juniper or Fortinet devices. So at first I'm going to the roots. I will add here chat Llama, and now we have button that is redirecting us to new function that we will create soon. But at first we need also to create new template, and I created chat Llama. So I used ChatGPT to create a chat, and that include Bootstrap 5. To make our interface look clean and responsive right away. Then we define our custom style in a style block to design the layout. So I have a couple divs here, and the first one is main container, then chat header for title bar, chat body where messages appear, and chat input for sending new messages. Here we have initial message. This makes the UI feel alive. And here we have created form within an input field and send button. This is where user types messages. And now the magic. We have script. We import jQuery so we can easily make asynchronous request to the server using get. We define variables, so we have here chat form element, user input field, and chat content area. And then we are defining avatars and names for the bot and the user. Then we have render function. We use a function called render chat bubble to dynamically add messages to the chat. This function takes the sender name, avatar alignment, and the messages text. It generates a message bubble using a template and adds it to the chat. We also scroll down to the bottom each time to show the latest message. And here we have function fetch bot reply that makes a get request to our Flask backend and sends the user message as query parameter. When the server replies, we display the bot's message on the left. If there is an error, we show a warning instead. Finally, we listen for the form submit event. When the user press enter or click send, we prevent the page from loading, get the typed message, render it and place on the right, clear the input field, and then call fetch bot reply to send that message to our backend. And that's it. We now have a fully working frontend. So let's go to our app.py and I will show you what I have here now. So at first I'm importing some libraries, then I have Flask config. We have here a connection to our MongoDB. Here is my Llama host. So this is IP of my Windows computer. Here we have roots, here forms, and here we have app.root to something like Nornir inventory or device inventory. And now we have chat with Llama, but the requested URL was not found on the server, so we need to add it. So we start by connecting to the Llama server using the client class from the Llama Python package. So what you can see here, I have from Llama import client. Let's go down. The server runs on port like that. And Llama host is our environment variable or config value that holds the IP or hostname where Llama is running. This allows our Flask app to send and receive messages from our local LLM like DevStral. This is the root that renders the actual chat page in the browser. When a user visits chat Llama, this function runs. So we need to do dev chat Llama. And we want to return render template chat llama.html and let's check how it looks now. Let's refresh and here we have our bot, but if we type something, we're getting error. So we need to build root get. This is the endpoint for the frontend JavaScript calls when the user sends a message. We grab the message parameter from the request and pass it into our helper function askLLM that we need to define. So let's define askLLM message and we can define here model, so devstral. This function will be the heart of our AI logic. So at first, create response, and that will be client generate prompt message, and I will remove that max tokens. And we are returning response.strip. And let's check if that will work. I made a mistake here. That should be client. And now let's test this again. How are you? And now we can go to CMD and check Llama PS. And as you can see, we're now using DevStral. And as you can see, we have here a response from our Llama. And maybe you have already noticed that something isn't quite right here. Right now, no matter what we type into the chat, The bot will generate a response, but it's not actually remember anything we've said before, and that's because our app is not using chat history, which is essential if we want our AI to understand the context or hold the conversation. So let's fix that. So at first, when someone opens the chat llama root, we should start with a clear session. So we need initialization here. So let's create a session and we will call it chat history. And here we are creating array where we need to create a dict, and that will be role, but here will be user. And at this point, we can use that prompt to determine who our bot is. So I'm creating prompt like, you are a professional network assistant, keep answers short, and he will respond with that instructions. So in this function, we are only changing that part. Right here, we don't need to change anything, but here we need to do chat history, and through session get, we're getting that chat history. Then chat history append role user content message, but function client and dot generate only sends a single prompt. Instead, we want to switch to client dot chat, which allows us to send a list of messages with roles like user and assistant. Let's update our function like this. And after that change, we also need to add our response to chat history, and then update variable session chat history with our chat history with these two messages. And we want to return response dot message content dot strip. And after that changes, we can check our bot. And now our bot can remember past messages and respond with context. So let's check that. This is my message. Here is a list of three Cisco devices with their host names. And in the next message, I will ask for something from that dict. But I've got an error, so let's check the code. And Copilot give me wrong answer, so it should be response message content strip. And let's check again. I will copy that, refresh, and let's go. He said that he understood that information. So let's ask which IP have firewall 1. And as you can see, this is the current answer. So our conversation is working. So thanks for watching. In the next episode, I will show you how to use function calling with an LLM and custom tools. For example, a function that connects to Cisco devices and pulls real network data. So thanks again and see you in the next one.